As a quick disclaimer, I reference using this water-based urethane. The brand is fine. Just use oil-based. I tried to hide it in the video, but all of my poster board started bubbling up and stuff because the water absorbed in the paperboard. So use an oil-based and not what I say, a water-based. Now for the video. Hello, beautiful people. I'm Ryan, and I have been hacking things my whole life. So I have a channel that I'm stepping up that teaches you digital design for free. So all types of creative media tutorials, check that out. It's linked below. I'm keeping all my maker videos on this channel. If you're new to my channel, I make things in my garage using four different robots: metal, laser, CNC, and 3D printing. Today we are going to be making very large, cheap wall art. Thanks for being here. Now, I'm going to clear coat this. That's why I'm going to wearing this ridiculously hot bib. By the way, it's hotter in the hackLAB than you think. This thing is 4x4, and includes 12 of these dollar prints, okay? I did my entire two garage doors. If you put together 12 of these dollar prints, let me give you a really cool one. Like, here's one of downtown New York. So I made one of a looking outside of a window in New York. So I went ahead and I printed $60 worth of these. And so I have over, I don't know what the math is, whatever the math is, 60 divided by 12. I have a lot of those, enough to do the entire garage. So I have some really cool designs. I have road signs, I have artwork, I have warehouses, I have a lot of stuff that's in these 17 by 14 tabloid, the largest size you can get. So cheaper prints online. So that was $12, plus I found the underlayment wood free in a dumpster of a construction site. Yes, that's illegal. But I guess if you don't get caught, I think it was still illegal. Don't do it. But I'm not your dad. Oh, since I'm not your dad, I do need to tell you something. Make sure you wear a mask anytime you use something like this stuff here. Just throw on an N95 mask. I don't know where I have one. Everyone knows what an N95 mask looks like. But wear one like that. So for these, after you're done gluing those, you're going to want to go ahead and put a clear coat on there. So once you're done, you're going to have to trim off this little tiny white edge that comes on the print. If you go to Harbor Freight, you can buy a really cheap cutter for around $20. Okay. This cutter does a great job with recreating. And once you're done, you simply go ahead and you build out your entire image on top of the board. And once that's done, you're going to want to place your clear coat. Okay, well, here's the magic. You're gonna have to print an image with 12 different separate images that comes into one. And that is what I'm going to talk to you about now. What you have to do is you download your image. It's gotta be pretty high resolution, okay? You're gonna build up an image that has, let me talk about this, one, two, three, four, 12 different artboards in a matrix, okay? Those 12 different artboards in a matrix are going to be slightly smaller than this. So there is going to be some overlap in the imagery, okay? But once you're done with that, you could be artistic about it. You could put like a gesso or another thicker clear coat on it. You could go ahead and do paint. You could just spray paint over everything and get a really cool graffiti, one of a kind look. It's just very similar to subway art. If you're familiar with subway art, people do graffiti over existing ads. So that's what that happens. So now we're going to put the clear coat on, and I've decided to use this ultimate polyurethane water-based paint. No sponsor. It's just that I like the fact that it says it's got some UV protection, but it's water-based, so it really won't smell up. Like, for instance, this smells, I smell. All right, enough of that. Okay, so once the clear coat's done, I went ahead and put it in two hooks, two nails on the wall that were leveled, and I'm able to put it into my new electronic area that I'm designing. And what's really cool, I'm taking a closet and converting it over to an electronic area. And what's cool about this is, since this is wood, I know that was loud, since that's wood, you can go ahead and screw things. Like, I'm going to be putting my shop light on top of, in the middle. I'm going to be covering up this seam where my shop light is, because I want that light close to my work surface so I can see, and the other stuff is going to be shelves. So I plan on using this for shelves, but it's a really cool backdrop and it gives me a really good feeling. So that was one of my favorite ones. I've done one in my front office that's a huge boombox radio that's next to my aquarium, and I really like that. But anyways, that's how I'm making cheap wall art. I'm taking these imagery and I am printing up these tabs. And if you, I'll probably do another one. This one is, let me see. This one's cool. I'm looking forward to this one. This is going to be a warehouse. So it's a big, huge warehouse image, because if you want that cool loft feeling, the key is taking your time and doing the overlap. Now, you do need to use spray adhesive for the things. You spray this down. If you have any parts that are coming up, go ahead and put in some quick, some glue sticks. Well, anyways, guys, that's it. I hope you make some big, cheap wall art today or tomorrow, or maybe not. Maybe you could just laugh at me here on YouTube. All right, whatever you do, make something that connects someone. I love you. Take care. I hope you have a great week. Bye.